In this video, I'm going to show you how to use masking for transitions in Adobe Premiere Pro. Hey there, I'm Mark Brown from Editor's Keys. Now, if you're into video editing or filmmaking, then consider subscribing to this channel because that's what we're all about. And in this little series, we're teaching you the best Premiere Pro tips, tricks, and hacks to help you edit faster than ever before. So I'm gonna show you how to mask in Adobe Premiere Pro, and it's a great way to connect two shots seamlessly to make your videos and transitions look better than ever before. One reason why I love masking is it can actually save shots too. So if someone walks past your camera during a scene, you think it could ruin your shot, but you can actually use that to your advantage. Let me show you how. So here we are in Adobe Premiere Pro, and these are the two clips we'll be working on for the first example. The first shot is a pan towards this sign, to then panning right, making the person cover the whole frame, to then transitioning into this shot outside. An important thing to remember when wanting to use the masking transition is to make sure the object or person fills the whole frame vertically in order to make this work. It also helps to have two shots that are moving in the same direction. So with these clips, they are both moving to the right. This will make the transition smoother. I'll now reset all the settings and show you how to do this. So you want to grab your first clip, and what you need to do is drag the clip out until the line that you're masking goes all the way through the frame. So with this clip, I'm going to be using the person's back and then cut the clip to where it reaches the end. So here it ends, cut the clip and use Command K. Now move to your second clip and place it one frame before where the first clip starts. So here you can see that's where you want to line up your next clip. That's your two shots lined up perfectly to then begin the masking. Now click onto the first clip and go to where the first clip starts, then go over to your effects panel to the opacity section and click on this little icon here, the free draw icon. Start drawing around your object. Now you'll see when you've drawn around your first object that the second clip has come up. To change this, just go over to where it says inverted and tick this box. Now your next step. Make sure you toggle all these keyframes to make a mask, and to make a path, you'll see that the mask is gone away. So just click back on this mask, mask one, to bring it up again. To make the masking a lot smoother, turn the feathering up to around 30 to 40 to soften the edges and lines. Now all you need to do is draw a mask out for each frame. Just repeat this process for each frame till it's completely out. If you want to create more points to fit the object, just click any part of the line to do so. If you accidentally move the mask or make a mistake, just press Command Z to undo. Once you've drawn through the whole clip and it's finished, go over it and look at the beginning of the mask, as you'll have a bit of what's gone over earlier, so just make sure you drag that out. If so, just drag the clip, then click on the mask icon to bring up the drawing again, and you can change and add more points to make it smoother. What I like to do is add a little bit of speed ramping to both clips to make it even more seamless. Here's the final outcome and some added sound effects and a color grade. So there we go, that's how you mask in Adobe Premiere Pro. And I just love masking because you can use it to save shots, as we showed there in the tutorial, or you can now go out and film more deliberately. Go film past some walls, some trains, some trams, some cars, and try and improve your transitions. Now I hope that's helped, and if it has, please leave a comment or a question below, and I promise I do get back to every single one. Now if you enjoyed that video, please hit that like and smash that notification bell, and I'll see you in the next one.